15 songs on the album, I think, is some added pressure, because a lot of people were calling their albums, or 5 songs, 6 songs, but that's an EP. You can't really call that an album. So I don't think people can say it's unfair of me to do 15 if it's within my ability. The album itself is a story, you know. Strength in Numbers is about collaborative efforts and what we can do when we come together as Africans. So it was logical to have all of these elements come together, and it meant that I was doing a lot of collaborating on the continent. And so, yeah, 15 songs is where it felt right, you know. And we also don't want to give the people too little, you know. I want to give people their money's worth, especially when people label you as a legend. You want to give people their money's worth. And so that's why we have those collaborations. You know, Calligraph Jones, Shay Shay, Lay Lizzie, the Burna Boy remix, Ice Prince, The Myth, Daddy Andre, Flex the Paper. We wanted to give the best quality of music at the moment. Vanessa MD, you know, and Strength in Numbers is it? It was definitely a Strength in Numbers just about us as individuals, how we come together more than the numbers online. And that's why every artist who was picked for this is at the top of their game. Every artist who's on the album is at peak in terms of what they do. So they may not have 10 million followers, but you go to their country and they shut down shows in a professional way. And, you know, there's a certain caliber of artist that I wanted on this project to show that Ugandans can hang at that level. When you get on a song with Vanessa, you know her image and her brand and what she's bringing to the table, you know, is going to be dope. A Lay Lizzie, a Burna Boy, a Ice Prince, they keep a certain standard, you know what I mean? So whether or not they're the biggest artist wasn't really important to me, but I knew that I just wanted them to be at a certain level. You know, that people are still figuring out, you know, girls in the industry are still figuring out how to catch up with Shay Shay's, one of her first singles. Love me right, right, now, 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 now. People see the video and the singing and the recording and the beat, and they're still trying to catch up with that. Those are the kind of acts that I wanted on the album for Strength in Numbers, you know, to show that Ugandans can compete at that level. And I think we definitely chose the right people for the album. These guys are people that I respect, people in the industry that are dope, and people that I have a rapport with, you know, because it would be weird if I looked at my album and it's all just a bunch of strangers or someone you've paid to do this song or, you know, for me, that's not real. Who I work with are people I have a rapport with, a back and forth with, people I don't mind spending time with. And that's what I want to, what's what I want to see when I look at an album. I don't want to see like, hey, we really tried to do good marketing in Mozambique. No, Lay Lizzie is really dope. He's really cool. But he's a guy that I know, you know. So I really wanted it to be family on this album, you know, with the theme being Strength in Numbers, and we accomplished that. The start had to have a serious tone to let you know the quality was different. People nowadays, they start an album, they want their club anthem to sell the album. But when you get to a certain level, 70 awards, I need to give people a work of art. I need to give people a piece of music, a real one that has flow, a story, beginning, middle, end, you know. And you don't just break straight into it, because I'm not at the level now. Well, I'm trying to get more awards. I've got 60 awards. I'm not trying to get more awards. I'm not trying to prove myself. What I'm trying to do is prove myself as an artist, to show why I've been regarded as one of the top rappers on the continent for the last 15 years. And to do that, I can't just be so desperately trying to push my hits in people's faces. You know, I need to show that, hey, I've got a body of work. I can battle. I can do underground. You know, I can get on commercial songs. I can get on Afrobeat. I can do all this versatile stuff while still keeping it true and keeping it real and keeping it Ugandan. And that, I think, is what a lot of artists lack. They just want to push their things in our face like it's some mechanical thing. Oh, I push this kind type of beat. Give me a raga beat because that's money. Give me this because it's money. For me, it's no longer about money. It's about making an impact. I want everyone from Jay-Z to King Saha to whoever else, you know, to Abdu, you know, everyone in the industry. I want them to be able to play the album and know that this is good music worldwide. Yes, of course, and that actually goes to testify that putting number 15 on the Best Silly Remix, anyone would be like, hey, let me put the Burna Boy song on number one because he's selling right now. But I put it at number 15 because it's a song that people wanted to hear, but it's a song that's already come out, so it's a remix. So I put the remix at number 15, you know, just as kind of like a mega bonus, you know, that people can enjoy. And he's my boy as well, and he's cool. I'm sure we'll do some work in the future, you know, but for now it was like, it was one of those remixes that came out and we weren't sure about whether to release it because he then had an issue with the South African beef that popped up with him and AKA. And we didn't know whether using a South African beat would really translate. So we didn't release the song when they were having the beef with him and AKA. But I was like, you know, now the coast is clear. Whether or not it's on a South African house beat, let's release it and let the people have it because they were expecting it. I said, hey, remix coming, and it never came. So, yeah, I'm glad, you know, Burna Boy is on there at number 15. And it's a dope way to close out the album with one of my boys. Man, the cover was really special. I wanted to represent Rubaga. I wanted to represent the people. You know, this kind of scene is an iconic scene you can only get in Africa. You know, when you have crowds amass in Europe and the States, it looks different. When you have a crowd pictured in Africa, in Uganda, it looks different. You know that we're coming for business. So I wanted that strictly business, you know, to reflect on the cover. And of course I had to, you know, get the Rubaga shirt out, you know, and represent my guys, NAV Corp hat on, you know, to represent my NAV Corp army. And, you know, just keep it 100, man. It's about strength in numbers, but not strength on numbers online. It's about what you can do and how you affect lives on street. You know, that's what's the most important thing. Strength in numbers as a project was just amazing. And I knew it had to do something bigger, larger. I knew that if people heard it, you know, further than Uganda, you know, it was bound to do something big. So flew to New York. I had a meeting there called in by the guys at Roc Nation. And I sat down and sort of talked about music as it is now. It's just a back and forth just to see where the game was at. And so we decided to get this album distributed through their sister company, a subsidiary called Equity. So I was like, yeah, we'll do this deal, but as long as we can get on another 100 Ugandan acts into this same deal. So I was like, if you give us access to this deal, we want to make sure that we try and allow other people to benefit from the same deal, those who they think are dope, through NAV Corp. And so they've allowed us to do that, and we're basically using this as a springboard to see how that goes. And if everything goes according to plan, you know, I'll be able to open up the doors now for a lot of other acts, which is really cool, because I'm on my way out and there are a lot of new acts that need a push bigger than just Uganda, bigger than just Kampala, bigger than just, you know, what we're doing here, bigger than East Africa. And I think we have the artists who are cool enough, or dope enough to compete worldwide. They just need access and opportunity. Yeah, as part of my deal, with the Equity and the distribution company, this CD was manufactured out there. So the CD was manufactured out there, but a lot of the profits that are coming from the album were detracting back to the people, especially in Corona time. And that's why I wanted to release the album now. So we are taking a hit as far as business is concerned, but we are using it to raise money to actually provide stuff and give, you know, Posho and some of the basics back to society from the sales of the album. So it feels really good to be able to do that. At the same point in time, I could have waited 4 or 5 months and just eaten profit for myself, but I knew that the album had to come out. I had promised the crowd that we'd be doing April 25th, so I was like, you know, let's unleash it, man. You know, what's the worst thing that can happen? Let's build up numbers and give the people something to hear while they're locked down. Ooh, Tio, what up, man? It's your boy, Nav. Yo, whoop, the album is finally out. Strength in Numbers. Make sure you guys go and get that. You can download it anywhere or go to one of your Boda Boda apps and search for Navio. Strength in Numbers, baby. It is officially out. Get this delivered right to your doorstep or get online, Spotify, Tidal, and more. All of the online stores, it's now out. amazing collabos as well. Calligraph Jones, Shay Shay, Ice Prince, Myth, Daddy Andre, Flex the Paper. The list goes on. Lay Lizzie from Mozambique, Vanessa MD, Joe McKinney from Tanzania. It's amazing. Thank you guys so much for your support and love. I hope you guys keep busy during COVID. Remember to stay safe and stay home. It's your boy Navio. It's all about strength in numbers. Let's give him hell.